What's up, guys? Welcome back to the TenorShare channel. If your iPhone screen got zoomed in like this, don't worry. It's because the zoom feature has been enabled in your settings app. But if you are in the lock screen state, it will cause you to be unable to unlock. Even when your phone is unlocked, you probably still don't know how to zoom it out. Fret not, today I'll show you 5 different ways to fix it. Step 1. Use 3-finger double tap. Hold out 3 fingers, then try double tapping on the screen. Easy, right? This gesture can toggle the zoom mode on and off. If this doesn't work, try restarting your device. Step 2. Force restart. For iPhone 8 and later models, quickly press and release the volume up and the volume down button. And finally, press and hold the side button until the Apple logo appears. This method often works. Now you can see your screen has zoomed itself out automatically. Step 3. Adjust zoom settings. If you're using an iPhone model with Face ID, you can turn on the zoom controller. Go to Settings, Accessibility, tap Zoom, Zoom Controller. Once you turn it on, you will find a steering wheel appearing on the screen. When you accidentally zoom in on the screen and forget how to zoom out, you can click the steering wheel to adjust the screen size freely. Of course, to prevent this from happening again so unexpectedly, you can turn off the zoom settings. Now your display size will stay immune to the gesture. Step 4. Disable zoom in iTunes or Finder. Connect your iPhone to your computer. Go to your device page. Scroll down and click Configure Accessibility. Go ahead and uncheck the box next to Use Zoom. Very simple. Now you go to Settings, you'll notice iTunes literally turned this feature off for you. Step 5. Use Recovery Mode of ReiBoot. Another way to fix it from a computer is using ReiBoot. Click on Enter Recovery Mode as the start. Once in, click on Exit Recovery Mode. See, this works too. Step 6. Repair iOS with ReiBoot. System issues may cause some errors, so let's fix them with standard repair and ReiBoot. Once connect your device, click the green start button. Choose the standard repair by default, so you don't have to worry about data loss. After downloading the firmware, you can start to repair it. Not only that, ReiBoot will also upgrade your system during the repair process. Once down, your screen should be back to normal. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up if you succeed in one of the methods. I will be grateful if you subscribe. Stay tuned for our next videos.